Hello everybody. In the last class, I have discussed open loop and closed loop system. It is my second lecture. Now, I will introduce transfer function. Here, our aim is to determine the stability of the system by using different methods like Routh criterion, root locus, Nyquist and Bode plot. All these method is applicable if we get transfer function of the system. That's why at first we need to find transfer function of the system. Contents: definition of transfer function, poles and zeros of a transfer function. Transfer function describes the relationship between the inputs to a system to the output from that system. It allows to design a system based on its required behavior by first constructing the desired transfer function and then working backward to a physical realization of that design. Transfer function of control system is defined as the ratio of the Laplace transformation of output response to the Laplace transform of input, assuming all initial conditions to be zero. If function of RT, function of CT and function of GT are the input, output and process or impulse function respectively, and corresponding Laplace transforms are RS, CS and GS, then the block diagram system can be represented as in figure. By definition, we get TS equal to GS equal to CS by RS, where GS or TS is the transfer function of the system, CS is the Laplace transform of output and RS is the Laplace transform of input. Laplace transform of differential equation. Mathematical models of most physical systems are characteristics by differential equation. The Laplace transform is a well-established mathematical technique for solving a differential equation. Many mathematical problems are solved using this transformation. Consider a linear system having input. The input-output relation can be described by following nth order differential equation. So this differential equation is An t to the power n Ct divided by dTn plus a n minus 1 d to the power n minus 1 ct divided by d t to the power n minus 1. Then next is a 1 d ct divided by dt plus a 0 ct. So this is the differential equation. Here coefficients a and b are constant. Taking Laplace transform of this differential equation, we know that Laplace transform of Ft equal to Fs. So, taking the Laplace transform of equation 1, An s to the power n, An minus 1, and this is s to the power n minus 1 plus A1, this is only s, and this is plus A0. And what is this? That means CS is common for all the part. This is CT, means consider CS. Then equal to, for RT we can write RS. Then RS is common. Then we get BM S to the power M plus BM minus 1 S to the power M minus 1. And this is B1 into S plus B0. So this is the equation 2. So, transfer function is CS by RS. So, CS by RS equal to, we get this one. So, this is the transfer function of nth order differential equation. Characteristic equation of a transfer function. The characteristic equation of a linear system can be obtained by equating the denominator polynomial of the transfer function to zero. Thus, the characteristic equation of the transfer function of equation 3 will be a n s to the power n plus a n minus 1 s to the power n minus 1 plus this plus a1 s plus a0 equal to 0. Characteristic equation can be explained with the help an example. Because we are assuming that the system is autonomous, for the sake of analysis, an autonomous system is one which runs even if the input is 0. Here the explanation: consider a series RLC circuit whose output we want to consider is the voltage of capacitor Vc and input is Vs. If the current in a circuit is I, taking KVL, then we get L di dt plus Ri plus 1 by C integration of I dt equal to Vs. Then taking Laplace transform, SLIS plus RIS plus 1 by CS into IS equal to Vs. So from this equation, we get IS is common, then LS plus R plus 1 by CS equal to Vs. If the output voltage is given Vc, then taking Laplace transform, VCS equal to IS by CS. Then we can have transfer function as Vc by Vs equal to 1 by Lc s square plus Rcs plus 1. Here the characteristic equation is denominator of this function. Now let's see why we want to put this 0. That is, there is no forcing function like Vs now. If Vs is 0, then we get the part Ls plus R plus 1 by Sc is equal to 0, which is nothing but the characteristic equation of the series RLC circuit. That's why characteristics equation is the denominator of the transfer function considered 0. Transfer function of open loop system. A system can be defined by its transfer function, which is a ratio of polynomials in the Laplace variables S, where input and output of the systems are RT and YT respectively, and GT represent the gain of the system, that means process. So this is block diagram of Laplace transform for open loop system. By a definition of transfer function, we get PS, that means Gs equal to Cs by Rs, where Cs is the Laplace transform of output and Rs is the Laplace transform of input, and Gs is the Laplace transform of forward path gain of the system. Transfer function of closed loop system. This is the closed loop system. Taking block diagram of closed loop system. This figure is block diagram of Laplace transform for closed loop system, where Rs is input signal, Cs is output signal, Es is actuating signal, Bs is feedback signal, Ts is transfer function of closed loop system, Gs is forward path transfer function, and Hs is feedback path transfer function. So the error signal is equal to Rs minus Bs. Here from this signal, Bs equal to Hs into Cs. So BS equal to put HS into CS. And what is CS? For this forward path gain, CS is the output and ES is the input. So CS by ES equal to GS. Then CS equal to, we get GS into ES. And put the value of ES. Then from this equation, CS is common. Then we get 1 plus HS equal to GS into RS. Then transfer function is CS by RS equal to, we get GS by 1 plus HS into GS. This is the block diagram of transfer function for closed loop system. Advantages and disadvantages of transfer function.
The advantages are pole, zero and characteristic equation can be determined by the transfer function. It helps to determine the stability of the system. Next one is, if transfer function is known, output response for any type of input can be determined easily. The disadvantages are, transfer function cannot be defined for nonlinear system. Next is, transfer function only defined for linear system. From transfer function, physical structure of the system cannot be determined.
Poles and zeros of a transfer function. A system is obtained defined in terms of the poles and zeros of its transfer function. You will see later that the location of poles and zeros gives a wealth of information about the behavior of a system. This document is only concerned with the creation of a pole zero representation and not its interpretation. Poles. Poles are the roots of the denominator of a transfer function. Let us take a simple transfer function as an example. T equal to GS equal to numerator divided by denominator. That means CS by RS.
Equal to BM S to the power M plus BM minus 1 S to the power M minus 1 plus B1 S plus B0. Divided by an s to the power an plus an minus 1 s to the power n minus 1 plus a1 s plus a0.
Here poles are the roots of denominator and can be evaluated by taking ds is 0 and is solved for s. Generally, the number of poles is equal or greater than zeros. Definition of zeros. Similar to poles, zeros are the roots of numerator of a transfer function. For same above the transfer function, zeros can be determined by taking ns equal to 0 and solving for s. Poles zeros plot in s plane. The plane in which the poles and zeros appears is the s plane of the Laplace transform. In general, the poles and zeros of a transfer function may be complex and the system dynamics may be represented graphically by plotting their location on the complex S. S is a complex variable. So S equal to, we consider sigma plus j omega, where sigma is a real part of S and omega is the imaginary part of S. So this is imaginary axis and this is real axis. This symbol consider for poles and this symbol consider for zero of the system. Pole zero representation of a system. Now that we have found and plotted the poles and zeros in a S plane. So this transfer function is given. So this is the denominator. If denominator equal to zero, then we get S equal to minus 4, minus 5 and minus 8. Then plot. This is S plane. So this one minus 4, minus 5 and minus 8. This is the real axis. So negative side of the real axis. So this is minus 4, minus 5 and minus 8. Next, calculate zeros of the system. Numerator equal to 0, that means ns equal to 0. Then we get s equal to minus 1 and s equal to minus 2. Draw s equal to minus 1 and s equal to minus 2. Next example, find the pole 0 representation of the system with the transfer function. Here, transfer function is given hs equal to this. So, these two create this form. Then denominator equal to 0, then we get s equal to minus 1 plus minus j 1. Another pole is s equal to minus 3. Then plot the poles. One is the, this is negative side, this one is the minus 1 plus j 1 and this is minus j 1. So these two are complex pole. Another pole is minus 3. Okay, then determine the zeros. This numerator is equal to 0, then we get s equal to minus 1 and s equal to minus 2. So this is minus 1 and this is minus 2. And this is the constant term, k equal to 3. Applications for pole zero plots. In shown in figure, this is the unstable region and this is stable region. Because if any pole present right hand side of the S plane, then the system is unstable. If all poles are present left hand side of the S plane, then system is stable. I will give all this explanation later. Third lecture is coming soon on mathematical model of dynamic system. Please follow the lecture. Thank you.